Methocarbamol is a CNS depressant indicated with rest, physical therapy, and other treatments to control the discomfort associated with various acute musculoskeletal conditions. In this video, let's find found. What is methocarbamol? What is methocarbamol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking methocarbamol? How does methocarbamol work? How to use methocarbamol? What is methocarbamol? Methocarbamol, sold under the brand name Robaxin among others, is a medication used for short-term musculoskeletal pain. It may be used together with rest, physical therapy, and pain medication. It is less preferred in low back pain. It has limited use for rheumatoid arthritis and cerebral palsy. Methocarbamol was developed in 1956 in the laboratories of A.H. Robbins, later acquired by Pfizer. What is methocarbamol used for? Methocarbamol tablets and intramuscular injections are indicated in the United States as an adjunct to rest, physical therapy, and other measures for the relief of discomforts associated with acute, painful musculoskeletal conditions. In Canada, methocarbamol, containing oral formulations, are sold over-the-counter for pain associated with muscle spasm. However, if these combination formulations include codeine, they are prescription only. What is methocarbamol? Methocarbamol, sold under the brand name Robaxin among others, is a medication used for short-term musculoskeletal pain. It may be used together with rest, physical therapy, and pain medication. It is less preferred in low back pain. It has limited use for rheumatoid arthritis and cerebral palsy. Methocarbamol was developed in 1956 in the laboratories of A.H. Robbins, later acquired by Pfizer. What is methocarbamol used for? Methocarbamol tablets and intramuscular injections are indicated in the United States as an adjunct to rest, physical therapy, and other measures for the relief of discomforts associated with acute, painful musculoskeletal conditions. In Canada, methocarbamol, containing oral formulations, are sold over-the-counter for pain associated with muscle spasm. However, if these combination formulations include codeine, they are prescription only. Pharmacodynamic. Methocarbamol is a skeletal muscle relaxant with an unknown mechanism of action. Methocarbamol has been shown to block spinal polysynaptic reflexes, decrease nerve transmission in spinal and supraspinal polysynaptic pathways, and prolong the refractory period of muscle cells. Methocarbamol does not act as a local anesthetic upon injection. In animal studies, methocarbamol also prevents convulsions after electric shock. Pharmacodynamic. Methocarbamol is a skeletal muscle relaxant with an unknown mechanism of action. Methocarbamol has been shown to block spinal polysynaptic reflexes, decrease nerve transmission in spinal and supraspinal polysynaptic pathways, and prolong the refractory period of muscle cells. Methocarbamol does not act as a local anesthetic upon injection. In animal studies, methocarbamol also prevents convulsions after electric shock. Half-life. The elimination half-life is 1.14 hours in healthy subjects and 1.24 hours in subjects with renal insufficiency. Older studies report half-lives of 1.6 to 2.15 hours. Dose. Muscle spasm. 1 g/im, additional doses at Q8HR until PO, not to exceed 3 g/day. Total parenteral dose should not exceed 3 g/day for greater than 3 days, unless treating tetanus. If condition persists, may repeat therapy after drug-free interval of 48 hours, 1,500 mg POQ6HR for 48 to 72 hours, not to exceed 8 g/day, then decrease to 4 to 4.5 g/day divided Q4-8HR tetanus. Adjunct therapy. Initial 1 to 2G4 injection, at 300 mg per minute, then. Additional 1 to 2G4 infusion, for total dose of 3G initially. May repeat 1 to 2G4 Q6HR until can give NG or PO. Total of 24G PO may be needed. Safety advice. Methocarbamol is classified as pregnancy category C, as it has not been systematically studied in pregnant women. In addition, based on animal studies, methocarbamol is known to cross the placenta and is excreted in breast milk. Dose. Muscle spasm. 1 g/4 IM, additional doses at Q8HR until PO, not to exceed 3 g/day. Total parenteral dose should not exceed 3 g/day for greater than 3 days, unless treating tetanus, if condition persists, may repeat therapy after drug-free interval of 48 hours, 1,500 mg PO Q6HR for 48 to 72 hours. Not to exceed 8 g/day, then decrease to 4 to 4.5 g/day divided Q4-8HR tetanus. Adjunct therapy, initial 1 to 2g4 injection, at 300 mg per minute, then. Additional 1 to 2g4 infusion, for total dose of 3g initially. May repeat 1 to 2g4 Q6HR until can give NG or PO. Total of 24 g PO may be needed.